in an Irish bar, walking along Charlestown, wishing you were Bannerstrand, holding your nephew's hands. We walked along the waterfront, up Bunker Town on Main. We met at the monument, where everyone knew our names. Our first kiss on 40 flights, our friends on the stoop on summer nights. The church door was always open as the bells rang out for you and me, for all to see on our wedding day. There's an immigrant soul.
Good evening and welcome to Charlestown Live. I'm Kathy Giordano and I'll be your host for this evening's show. Abby Gray was supposed to be here. She couldn't make it, so I hope you're not too disappointed. But I'm back again, and it's not by popular demand. I would love to see Abby sitting here. She's fine. She's just too busy tonight. Before we open, let me thank our partner, Charlestown Against Drugs, Chad, and our sponsors. It's the Partners Healthcare, including MGH Charlestown Healthcare Center, MGH Institute of Health Professionals, Spalding Rehab Hospital, in the MGH SHOP program. Without their help, we couldn't bring the show to you. And let me say that starting last week and from now until the end of the year, Charlestown Live will be urging our viewers and guests to donate to the Harvest on Vine food pantry in Charlestown. Their need is great. Now serving over 700 families on a monthly basis, that need is big. It is our hope that you will send a donation or drop off non-perishable food to their drop-off sites at the Cooperative Bank, 201 Main Street, the Food Pantry at 49 Vine Street, or the Parish Center at 46 Winthrop Street. At this point, they are collecting canned soup, stew, chowder, and instant packages of soup and noodles. Of course, any other non-perishable food items will be greatly accepted. last week they had I think they do it twice a month, and they had their people come in to pick up food. They emptied their shelves. They gave over 10,000 pounds of fresh and packaged foods to the needy. They emptied their shelves, folks. We need to help them, so remember that. Before we get into the show, let me please talk to you on a personal note. Most of you have heard by now the great tragedy that happened in Charlestown last night. There was a drive-by shooting on Main Street in between Sullivan Street and Salem Street. Two young men were hit by gunshots. These are two innocent young men who were walking on the sidewalk. One is in very critical condition. The other is serious but stable. I ask you to please pray for them and their families and their friends at this terrible, terrible time. Okay, with that, let me please talk about tomorrow night, Friday night, November 7th, the second annual Veterans Dinner will take place at the KFC Hall. Cocktails at 7 p.m. and dinner served at 8 p.m. It's sponsored by the Abraham Lincoln Post 11, all past and present Charlestown veterans, and presently active duty personnel, plus their guests, are invited. There's a small fee at the door, nothing to worry about. For more information, call Joe Zavante at 617-477-7494. And don't forget, Tuesday is Veterans Day, November 11th. If you see a veteran, thank him for his service, whether a present one now in the service or one who has served in the past. Thank them for their service. So with that, I'm going to introduce our guest for tonight's show, Gayle Lombardo from Santander Bank. Gayle, thank you so much for being here tonight.
Thank you so much for having me.
So let me ask you to start off. Tell us a little bit about yourself, Gayle.
Okay, my name is Gayle Lombardo. I am the.
What did I say?
I know.
Did I say Lombardo?
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay, great.
I am the small business banker from Santander, and I cover Charlestown and the immediate areas around Charlestown. So I've been with the bank for about a year. And in that year, I've built up some very, very nice partnerships, both within the community and with some of our business partners in Charlestown. So I'm pleased to be part of it. We're here to serve the community, and we have some wonderful services and products.
That's great. And you have gotten involved in the community. You
yes,
were just telling me about some of the things you've been involved in. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
So you jumped right in, and you're one of us now.
Well,
that's great.
Honorary.
I want to open a business, Gayle.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Fresh, I'm new at this. What do new business owners need to know when they're starting out?
Well, a couple of things. I mean, it sounds pretty... the normal way to do things is you have a great idea, you want to, you know, open a business, you want to sell something. I think the things that small business owners need to do is do their research, educate themselves, understand what their competitors are doing, what technology is available to their competitors, how they operate, and then see if that's how, you know, they want to model themselves or what they want to do better than that. And also, every business owner I would recommend needs to have a couple of very good partnerships, one with an accountant, one with an attorney, and one with a bank. So those are the things that I would advise any small business owner before they do anything, before they get into looking at space or doing any of those things where they'll be entering into contracts, that they consider all these things and talk to subject matter experts.
So they walk into the door fresh, mm-hmm. brand new. Is there anything they should bring with them, a plan for the business, or?
Well, it depends. I mean, the first time that we see many customers is when they're coming in to open up a checking account.
Okay.
Checking account, savings account. That's pretty basic. In order to do that, you need to have your identification of anyone who will be signing on the account, as well as what they call your tax identification number. And those things, they're resources you can sign up online. You can register with the Secretary of State. So there are multiple numbers that you can get through different resources. And then you have to have the signers. Whoever is going to sign needs to be present to sign, and it needs to be done in front of us. That's something that a lot of people forget. When it comes to securing loans, it gets a little bit more complicated because we do need to have 2 years tax returns for the business, 2 years personal tax returns, and a number of, you know, other smaller documents that we would need as well. And they also have to bring patience because it doesn't always happen in 2 days.
Absolutely. But they've come to this point. They're serious.
Absolutely.
So, and you're going very gently with them, I'm
Absolutely.
Sure.
Absolutely.
What is the major pain point that business owners face?
Well, I think right now, with the economy doing what it has, and hopefully we're seeing a rebound, cash flow is always an issue for a lot of the folks that I see on a daily basis, and some of it is seasonal, so they have issues with, you know, cash flow on a seasonal basis. So they'll come in and they'll be looking for some sort of relief, maybe a line of credit. So that is something that every bank offers. So again, I think, to be fair, every customer needs to do their research and look at what, you know, all your banks are doing, and so you can come in and you can have an educated conversation with the banker.
That's very smart.
Mm-hmm.
I forgot to mention, this is a live call-in show. We welcome your call, 617-708-3290. It's up on the screen. Give us a call. Excuse me. What does a typical business owner need to begin the process of getting a loan or a line of credit?
Okay, we kind of touched on that
yeah.
a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
So,
excuse me.
For instance, I spend a lot of my time on the road. You can either come to me or I come to you, whatever is easier. We fill out an application. I ask again, 2 years tax returns on the business, 2 years personal tax returns, a debt schedule, and maybe an accounts receivable aging report. And that will give the bank a very good snapshot of what your credit is like.
We have to pause. We have a phone. Okay. Hello, phone call. Hello, caller.
Hello, ladies. How are you tonight, girls?
Hello, Mr. Boyle. How are you?
Hi, Phil.
Very well. I just want to let people know that Ms. Lombardo was very active in the community. I don't know if you've seen her last week, Cookie, but she was at the Walk for the Cancer for Hope, I mean the Stroll for Hope.
She told me, yes.
And the bank helped support us.
Yes.
She's very active with the Boys and Girls Club.
She was at the morning
and she
breakfast.
She walks around the town constantly trying to get involved, and I think it's great to have somebody new in the town that wants to get involved with the community, so I thank her very much on behalf of the community people.
She told me that she even visited you in your office hours down at Zume's.
Yeah, but mine aren't as long as hers. Mine are short hours.
Well, thanks, Billy. So tomorrow's
right,
coffee's
you...
on me.
Did you hear that, Bill? Tomorrow she's buying you a cup of coffee.
Okay, well, as long as it's from her and not the Santander Bank, I don't want to get in trouble.
Sounds good.
Thank you for calling in, Bill.
All right, thank you. Good night, girls. All
thank
right.
you.
And for those who don't know, that's one of our co-hosts, Billy Boyle. We have another phone call. Hello, caller. One second. Here we go. Hello, caller.
Kathy.
Yes.
Kathy.
Here.
This is Buzzy.
How are you?
This is Buzzy.
How are you, Buzzy?
I want to excuse, I just want to have excuse myself for taking away from the bank business. You just said something great at the beginning of the program. Thank you for recognizing the kids.
Oh, God love them. Yes.
Thank you, Aunt.
Thank you, Buzzy. Pray for them. Thank you. God love them. Okay, did you want to add anything more? That what is the typical business owner? What do they need? Is there anything else?
No, I think we've pretty much covered. Again, I think it's important for business owners to understand we're there to help, and we do our best. And but the loan process isn't always as quick as you know the customer would like to see. So if they have all of this information, it makes things go go along a lot quicker.
So it's wise for them when they're just about ready to sign the legal document, they come to the bank and talk to you because it still takes a while.
Absolutely.
And the permitting process isn't the easiest thing. I know the mayor of Boston is working on speeding it up. He's working very hard, but it's still a permitting process that they have to go through.
It's a process for on the loan side. So, again, you know, if we take some time and we talk about it, then I think that if both sides know what the expectation is, it's a lot easier.
And I just met you this evening, Gayle, and I can tell you folks, she is so easy to talk to. I mean, piece of cake. Okay, how important is it that the business owners or their personal credit relative to a business loan? So their personal credit, line of credit, how important is that if they're going into business?
Well, one thing that I think customers understand but sometimes they forget is that that business is a business, but when we look to do lines of credit or loans, we're also looking at the character and the capacity of the owner and their ability to pay that loan back. So there's no better way to figure out how well, you know, whether or not we want to do business together than to make sure that that business owner, their character and capacity matches that of the business. So if a customer's credit is not where it should be, and there are different parameters, you know, numbers and things like that that are important, but I would recommend that all business owners pay very close attention to their personal credit as well as their business credit.
So would you suggest this is the first thing they do is to bring up their credit rating?
Personal? I would say before, if you think that your credit, you have issues on the personal side, I would spend quite a bit of time, you know, trying to address that. And again, I'm not a tax accountant, I'm not an attorney, but those resources are available and folks should do everything they can to make sure that both sides of it.
It only makes sense, Gayle.
Absolutely.
You know, I wouldn't blame a bank if they, if a person never paid their bills, why would you give them money to run a business? Anything else that you want to tell folks about it?
No, I would just like to say, you know, I'm blessed to work in Charlestown and the people have been absolutely wonderful. And anything that I can do and anything that they need, they should not hesitate to call. And I can come to them. They don't have to come to me.
That's great. Now, the branch in Charlestown is on Main Street?
It's on Main Street and Rutherford. So one door is on Rutherford and one side is on Main Street. So it's the old Sovereign Bank, so people remember that.
Okay.
And so we're right kind of at that corner.
Very good. Very good. And now, if people wanted to call you tomorrow, say, and start the process, what is your phone number? How can they reach you?
Best number to reach me at is 617-242-2182.
2182. And there it is up on the screen, folks, and we'll show it again before we leave the program. Now, Billy mentioned it. Tell us some of the things that the bank has been involved in since they came into Charlestown. Now, Billy said the Stroll for Hope.
The Stroll for Hope. I'm involved with the Y.
Wonderful.
The Y, and also, you know, I help out. I'm on the Chamber of Commerce. I'm a board member of the Chamber of Commerce.
Wonderful.
So I think it's important to the bank. We rebranded Sovereign Bank about a year ago to Santander, and we've made big strides, I think, you know, in getting involved in the community, getting our name out there, and really wanting to make a difference. There are so many wonderful organizations in Charlestown,
yeah,
as there are in every town. I grew up in Alston, so Charlestown, I kind of feel like a townie.
And late, folks, we both went to the same high school.
Yes, we did, Mount St. Joseph.
Mount St. Joseph, different years, as you can tell.
A little bit, couple
yeah.
of years.
Yeah, oh, yeah, couple of decades.
But, so it's, yeah. You know, banks, there are many banks. There are many banks
yes.
to choose from. And like I say, you know, every day, people do business with people that they like and people
yes.
that they're comfortable with.
Yes.
And people shouldn't be afraid to ask questions. You know, we might be bankers, but we don't own retail. So there's learning opportunity for both sides. And I can't tell an owner about their business, but they need to be open to listening to what the bank needs as well, because it has to be advantageous for both sides.
Of course. Of course it does. And as long as people have that attitude walking in the door to any bank.
Absolutely.
The bank's there to help them. They're not
Absolutely.
To harm them, and they're not to stop them on their dream.
Right.
Okay? And there is a lot to do to open a business, I'm sure.
Really is.
And I imagine the first thing is location, location, location.
Location, location.
Can be a problem in Charlestown. Really.
A little bit.
Yeah, with the price. And then just to have an open space.
Yeah.
You know, a lot of the property along Main Street and other main thoroughfares in Charlestown, when a store closed, they made a condo out of that
right.
That site. So there are really not too many storefronts in Charlestown.
Right.
So you're very lucky to get one if you
Absolutely.
Can.
Absolutely.
And and business is good, and the neighborhood really appreciates new businesses coming
Absolutely.
Into the town.
Absolutely.
Well, I know that the Chamber of Commerce has been active.
Chamber is doing everything possible to make a difference and
yes.
To help bring new businesses in,
mm-hmm.
help businesses that are currently there, you know, and just mm-hmm. get involved. Again, it's everybody needs to get involved. Everyone in the community helps businesses thrive, or they help businesses
right. Like
fail.
Abby always said, shop 02129.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
100%.
Mm-hmm.
100%.
And that's how we keep the money in the town.
Absolutely.
You know, and there are a lot of great stores that you can get what you need
in
the community. We're really, really lucky.
It really
and
is.
A lot of wonderful restaurants that people can go to.
Absolutely.
Take out, sit in. I mean, it's we're very lucky,
yep.
and it's expanding all the time.
Absolutely.
So keep up your good work.
Well,
get
thank you.
Involved. Come
thank
and see
you.
The different things, and you meet new people. And,
Absolutely.
And I'll be looking for you at the next event. Lord knows there's enough going on in Charlestown
yes,
any
is.
Given weekend. So, and also people, folks. I didn't have a time tonight, I wasn't expecting to be here, to jot down all the events that are taking place this week. So please pick up a copy, it's free, of the Charlestown Patriot Bridge. And they list on the second and third page everything that's coming up. And there are a lot of wonderful events that I think you'd like to partake in between now and, of course, right into November. And as we're getting ready for the holiday seasons, I know it's a little late to start a Christmas club, but does your bank have a Christmas club?
You know, Christmas clubs are almost becoming kind of a thing of the past.
Are they?
They are. And, but, you know, again, I would ask for folks who are looking for an interesting way of doing banking to come on in and talk to us. I think a lot of people have heard about one of the products that we have
mm-hmm.
called our Extra 20 program,
mm.
which we pay folks $20 a month to actually bank with us.
Isn't that something?
Yes. So it's for if a individual has at least $1,500 a month direct deposited into an account, they will get a certain amount of money. If they pay two bills out of their account, they will get some more money. So I would, again, not here to push specific
mm-hmm.
things, but if you, it's
so
a nice way of saving money.
So if someone has their check Monthly check,
direct
weekly
deposit.
They automatically get.
They do.
Anytime you write out two or more checks, you get a
little bit more. And that's a nice way.
That's a great incentive.
That's almost kind of like a Christmas club fund.
Yeah, that is. That is. So if you put that back into your account here.
I promised I wouldn't push too much, but I would recommend for folks to come on in and take a look at that product. It really is a great one.
Yeah. Anything else that's special to your bank that...
Right now, interest rates being what they are, mm-hmm. I mean, 0.90 doesn't sound like a whole lot, but we also have a money market fund that is offering 0.90 with some parameters around that. So, mm-hmm. Again, you know, I mean, I think to be fair, you know, every bank is doing a nice job. So I would say come on over and talk to us.
Fantastic. Okay, we have to wrap up. Anything
Great.
You want to say in closing?
No, thank you very much. And my heart goes out to the two boys that were hurt the other night.
And their families. God love them. Gayle, thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
It was a pleasure meeting you.
Thank you.
And talking to you and finding out about the bank. That is great. You'll have to come back someday.
Absolutely.
All right, and I look forward to seeing you around town.
Sounds good.
Well, that's it. We're going to wrap it up here, folks. Again, I ask sincerely for your prayers for these two young men, their families, and their friends. It's very difficult in Charlestown right now. To be honest with you, the neighborhood is outraged that this happened. It can happen in any neighborhood. It has happened in Boston before. It's just hit us very hard where we know these families so well. And like in other neighborhoods, innocent victims. So we, if I have any more news on the condition updates, if you tune us in on Facebook, Charlestown Live, I'll update that message board there and let you know, so check in on us. So with that, let me say good night, Charlestown. Take care of each other as you always do and as you are doing right now. God bless Charlestown. Now and forever. Good night.
Remember Charlestown, now and forever. God bless Charlestown. Good night.